Okay, we are going to discuss today. There are two important derivation. First one is length of path of contact. Length of path of contact. So here, as it we discussed yesterday, length of path of contact means when two gears are meshing. I will show that figure. Yeah, here. When two gears are meshing each other, the point AP, when the beginning of engagement to the pitch point, that is called path of approach. And when the point of P to C, when the beginning of pitch point to end of engagement, that is called point of recess. So therefore, the point A to C is called path of contact. That is called up to here only the teeth will be contact. After this, there is no teeth will be contact. So that is we are going to discuss what may be the length of that path of contact will be there. So for this, they consider these two figures. So this is a line diagram. When what is this diagram indicate is this one only. When two gears are meshed like this, we are going to consider the length of path of contact. So here, sir, class martta idare bartare. Okay, this is I'll show you. This is one gear and this is another gear. So here, the first circle, what you can see, this is called dedendum circle. You can see that this is the dedendum and center one is the pitch circle and this is called addendum. You can see this is the dedendum, this is the pitch circle and this is the addendum, or we can call this also base circle. And similarly, opposite gear will be the same thing. So this is the addendum, pitch circle and this is dedendum. Now here they considering let M, when two gears are meshed, the what is the curve you can able to see here. So that curve is nothing but this one. This is one profile and another profile, this. This is one profile when two gears are meshed. This is one profile, you can see this curve, no? This curve and another curve is this curve. So that curve only we shown here. We not shown that like a teeth, we shown here. So therefore, when these two gears are meshed, the pitch point is the pitch circle going to be contact at one common point. That is called pitch point. That is called P. This is called P. So this is called pitch point. Therefore, here let MN is a common tangent. They drawn one the common tangent between these two. This is the tangent line. You can see this tangent line passing through the base circle. You can see now here to the second gear. So this is called gear and bottom one is pinion. This is driven. This is bottom one is driver. When this rotate, gear will be rotate. So this is driven driver, that is pinion gear. And upward is the gear. So let MN is the common tangent. You drawn one common tangent. This is MN is equal to the common normal at point of contact to the teeth. That means here. The addendum circle cut the common tangent MN at point E. When this going to be drawn, MN, the line which is passing through this, the addendum. 1 minute. Principal. Okay, as we so discussing that, we derive the length of contact by considering these two types of gears. One is first upward is gear, and this is pinion. And this is the driver and this driven member. So therefore, the red color circle, what you can see, this is the dedendum circle. For this is for pinion and this for addendum. And center one is the pitch circle. And this one is the addendum circle for the gear. And this one is the addendum circle for the pinion. Now they are considering MN is the common to the base circle. So this is the base circle. Red color is the base circle as well as addendum. For that, they are going to draw one common tangent line. So therefore, this base circle, common tangent to the base circle is equal to the common normal at point of contact. Means where this circle, where this tangent going to be cut the circle, there you are going to draw one normal line. You can see here, one minute. You can hang at the guru. You can see O2M is the normal to this tangent and O1N is normal to this tangent. That is what they're saying is equal to the common normal at point of contact, where this tangent going to be contact with this base circle, and there you're going to draw the one normal lines. That is O1N and O2M is the normal lines. So therefore, the addendum circle cut the common tangent MN at point E. The addendum circle cut the common tangent MN at point E and F. You can see now where is the addendum circle for this gear is, this is the addendum circle. So where this addendum circle cut the MN tangent line, and that point is called E. Similarly for the pinion, this is the addendum circle where this MN line will cut this addendum circle of the pinion, that point is called as F. Is the intersect point for the MN line for the gear, and F is the intersect point for the tangent for the pinion is F. Therefore, let O1P is the pitch circle radius. O1P, you can see O1P, where these two gears are going to be, pitch circle going to be come in contact, that is P. That is the pitch circle radius of the gear, and O1 is the addendum circle radius, O1E, O1 to E. You can see here O1 to E is the addendum circle radius, that is RA. R, capital R, is the pitch circle radius. Similarly, ON is the base circle radius. You can see ON is the base circle radius. There are three types of radius. One is capital R, capital RA, and ONN, O1N. Capital R is the pitch circle radius for the gear. Capital RA is the addendum circle radius for the gear. ON is the base circle radius. Therefore, ON is the base circle radius of the gear, that is equal to O1P cos phi, that is equal to R cos phi. How we got this? That is, you can see now, they are considered one triangle. What is a triangle? Carefully observe the triangle now. You can observe the triangle O1NP. O1NP. You can able to see the one right angle triangle here. You can see this is the perpendicular symbol and this is a perpendicular symbol. Therefore, ONP one right angle triangle, as well as O2MP is one more right angle triangle. Now, what they're saying is this O1N is called O1P cos phi, and that is equal to R cos phi. How they called? You can see, you can apply this for this triangle cos rule, which is this for this triangle, you can apply cos rule. You not to identify first cos rule or sine rule, if you want to apply the trigonometric rule, as I told, first we need to identify which is the opposite, which is the base, and which is the hypotenuse. How to identify? As I told, so this is phi, and opposite one is one opposite side. This is the opposite side, and this is the perpendicular, and perpendicular line always opposite side we called as hypotenuse. So therefore, this is hypotenuse, and obviously this is become adjacent. Therefore, we need ON1. We apply the cos rule now for this ONP for this triangle. If you apply that cos rule, cos R, this is capital R, not small r, it is capital R is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse. What is adjacent for this triangle? O1N, and hypotenuse is O1P. O1N divided by O1P. That is what he written. We required O1N. Therefore, O1N is equal to cos phi into, this is cos phi into O1P. Therefore, what is we can call as O1P as? You can see O1P. We can call as pitch circle radius R. Therefore, we called as O1N as cos phi into R. O1N as cos phi into R. cos phi into r. You understood this triangle? They consider this triangle by cos phi is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse, that is on by o1p. Therefore o1n is equal to cos phi into o1p. o1p we can call as radius of the pitch circle. Understood this one? How they got this R cos phi? Similarly, here in a pinion side you come, small r called the radius of the pitch circle of pinion. Ra is called the addendum circle radius of the pinion. And also O2M is the base circle radius of the pinion. How we consider here, same thing you consider here now. And this angle we called as phi, and here also same thing phi. Now O2P is the, as I told, base circle radius of the pinion, that we called as small r. And O2F is the addendum circle radius of the pinion, that is Ra. And O2M is the base circle radius of the pinion, what we can call as, again similarly you can apply the trigonometric rule here. Consider this triangle O2MP, again identify which is adjacent hypotenuse. This is the phi, and therefore definitely this is become opposite side, and this is 90 degree, definitely this is become hypotenuse. So therefore if you want to, you apply the cos rule now. Again, what is cos phi become? So this is cos phi is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse. Which is adjacent? Definitely this is the adjacent. Adjacent is equal to O2M divided by hypotenuse. What is hypotenuse? O2P. Therefore, O2M we can call as O2P into cos phi. What is O2P we can call as? O2P we can call as small r. O2P we can call as small r. You can see this is small r, not capital R. This is small r. In the same way how we consider here, in the same way you consider this. So next step, here O2M is equal to cos phi into small r. Therefore, length of path of contact. Where is the length of path of contact? You can observe now where the two gears are going to be in contact. From E2P is the path of approach, P2F is the path of recess. Therefore, totally EF we called as path of contact. That means when these two gears are mesh, up to this here the two teeth are in contact. After that, it will be, there is no contact. Therefore, EF is equal to what we can call as PE plus PF, that is path of approach plus path of recess. Path of approach plus path of recess. EP plus PF, where EP is the path of approach and PF is the path of recess. So therefore, what we can do, keep EP and transfer PF this side, that for EP become EN minus EP is equal to, again here, according to this diagram, what is EP we can call as? EP we can call as EN minus PN. How? We'll see. EP is equal to EN. Yeah, you can observe here. EN minus PN will give the EP length. You can see now, EP is equal to EN minus PN. in this, if you subtract this, what is remaining, you'll get EP value. That is what they're showing here. EP is equal to EN minus PN. Let's call this is the equation number one and this is equation number two. Again, they consider triangle O1PN. O1PN. Where is O1PN? O1PN. Now you can apply the sine rule. What is sine rule? Opposite by hypotenuse. So already told which is opposite and which is hypotenuse, which is adjacent. Opposite this one, that is PN divided by hypotenuse is O1P. That is what they applied here. You can observe now. Sin phi is equal to PN divided by O1P. Therefore, sin phi into O1P is equal to, we can call as PN. What we can call as O1P? We can observe in the diagram. O1P we can call as radius of the pitch circle of gear, capital R. Therefore, R into sin phi is equal to PN. Similarly, you consider the triangle O1EN. O1EN. You can see here one more triangle. O1EN. Now, this is also a like right angle triangle because N is at a 90 degree. Therefore, for this triangle, you can observe, you can apply the Pythagoras rule. You can apply the Pythagoras rule. So, Pythagoras rule, that you know that which is the hypotenuse. Again, 90 degree opposite always hypotenuse. Therefore, O1E square is equal to EN square plus O1N square. According to the Pythagoras rule, the sum of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of square of other two sides. Therefore, EN square become O1E square minus O1N square. Therefore, square if you transfer to the right hand side, therefore that is become root. Now, what we can call as O1E according to the diagram, O1E, we can call this as radius of the addendum, that is RA. We can call as RA. Similarly, what we can call as O1N, O1N already you know, that is cos phi into R. That you substitute, that is whole square will be there. Therefore, RA square minus R square cos square phi. Now, you substitute this EN as well as PN value in place of equation number 2. Here, in place of equation number 2. Therefore, EP is equal to EN means you can substitute this value. EN means you can substitute this value and PN means you substitute this value. Therefore, you'll get like this. Let's call this equation as 3. Now, path of recess. Path of recess is PF. So, what is PF? We can call it as MF minus MP. You can see in the diagram. PF is equal to MF minus MP. MF here. MF minus MP will give the path of recess. I will show you once again. PF, path of recess is PF is equal to MF minus MP. If you subtract this length from this length, then you will get PF. That PF is called path of recess. P is called path of approach. Therefore, path of recess is equal to MF minus MP. Now we need to calculate what is MP and what is MF. For that, we need to consider the triangle O2MP. Where is O2MP? I already shown before. O2MP, you apply the against sine rule. Against sine rule means which is opposite, this opposite and 90 degree opposite the hypotenuse. Therefore, opposite by hypotenuse is sine rule. MP divided by O2P. MP divided by O2P. Therefore, I need MP. Therefore, MP become O2P into sin phi. What is O2P? We can call it as, according to the diagram, it is radius of the pitch circle. Radius of the pitch circle of pinion. Therefore, again, you consider one more triangle. How we consider for the gear? Similarly, here consider for the pinion. There is one more triangle. That triangle is O2MF. O2MF. We can see now where is O2MF. O2MF. For this one more triangle, right angle triangle, you apply the Pythagoras rule. This is the opposite hypotenuse. Therefore, O2F square is equal to M O2 square plus BM square. O2 not BM. O2F is equal to O2M square plus MF square. Therefore, I need MF. Therefore, you keep this one term and transfer this side. That is become O2F square. Here square will be there. Square is missed. Here O2F square. Okay. Now, therefore, MF is equal to O2F square minus O2M square. Square, if you transfer to the right hand side, that is become root. What we can call as O2F and O2M, we already know O2F means nothing but R, small r, Ra, and O2M is nothing but R into cos phi. Here, we already derived that. So therefore, substitute this MF value as well as MP value in equation number 4. Therefore, path of recess become MF minus MP. You substitute these two values. Therefore, that is become root of Ra square minus R square cos square phi minus R into sine phi. Let's call this equation number 5. We got path of approach as well as path of recess. Equation 3 and equation 5 is the path of approach and path of recess. So therefore, if we add these two, what you will get? Path of contact. Therefore, that is equation number 5 and equation number 4. You substitute in 1, then you will get path of approach is this one, this much. Path of recess is this much. Therefore, now we can simplify this. What is the simplification is? EF is equal to root of Ra square minus R square cos square phi. And as it is, you keep it Ra square minus R square cos square phi root. Here, we can call minus R sin phi plus minus R sin phi and minus small r sin phi. We can call it as sin A plus B form. Therefore, sin phi into R plus capital R plus R. So this is the equation for the path of contact when two gears are mesh. That is equation number 6. This is what you have to be derived. Suppose in the case, if driver and driven has equal number of teeth, if driver and driven, that means what we consider in a gear and pinion, if now it is not equal number of teeth. That's why it is one is bigger, gear is, pinion is small. But now it is equal number of teeth, then what happened? Definitely the radius of the addendum becomes same because it is same size. Ra is equal to capital Ra is equal to small Ra, as well as base circle radius also becomes same. And that time what happened, this equation? So you can substitute in place of here, small r, you can substitute the capital R. That means R square minus root of R square, Ra square minus R square cos square phi plus Ra square minus small r means I can substitute as capital R, and Ra means I can small Ra means I can substitute at capital Ra minus sin phi R plus small r means I can substitute capital R. Therefore, if you simplify this, this is become 2 times of root of Ra square minus R square cos square phi minus R of sin phi, because it is become 2R, no? I taken 2 already outside, common. Therefore, this is the case when both gears and pinions having equal number of teeth. And this is the equation number 6 is the when both gear and pinions is not having equal number of teeth. So this is path of contact derivations. And also, suppose if you want to find arc of contact. Arc of contact is CD. You can see. Circular, you consider arc of contact is this much. This circular is there, no? CD, this one. CD, if you consider. Similarly, arc of contact CD is equal to arc CD is equal to arc GH because both are same. Arc CD is equal to arc GH. You can see pinion side CD and gear side CD of the pitch circle. It is same arc length will be there here. This CD and GH, both arc length is equal. Therefore, arc of CD is equal to arc of AB by
cos phi. Arc of CD is equal to arc AB by cos phi. Arc AB, where is arc AB? You can see arc AB. You can see this is the arc AB and phi. I will show you the phi. It is not there in the diagram. Phi is here. This is also called as phi, pressure angle. Now this arc CD we can call as cos phi times of, what is that? Arc CD is equal to arc AB by cos phi. Therefore we know arc AB, it is nothing but, arc AB is nothing but path of contact of EF. You can see now arc AB, arc AB nothing but path of contact EF. This arc is nothing but path of contact EF. Therefore we can substitute a arc AB as path of contact EF. Therefore arc of contact become path of contact EF divided by cos phi. So this is the arc of contact and this is the path of contact. If path of contact they ask means only up to here you do it. If arc of contact means up to here you do it, and this is not there extra. Again it is repeated. So this complete the derivation of path of contact as well as arc of contact. Very, very important one.